Hey guys, so now we're going to focus on a specific type of ring called an annuline. So annulines, or polyolefins as they're sometimes called, are monocyclic hydrocarbons, one ring, that are fully conjugated. So that means that to be an annuline, you need to be only one ring, and you need to have alternating single bonds and double bonds, like you would find in benzene, okay? Now, due to their simple structure, due to the fact that you can always predict that it's going to be a single bond, double bond, and it's going to alternate, the names of these annulenes can be simplified to just the number of carbons in the ring, and then put it around a bracket, and then annulene. So, actually, if you think about it, a benzene is a type of annulene, right? So, benzene can also be simplified to the name 6-annulene, which is pretty cool. So if you're just walking around campus and you see someone with a clutch shirt on and has a benzene, you can be like, that's a mighty fine 6-annulene you have there. And they're from clutch, so they're going to know what you're talking about, and they're going to give you a fist bump right in the middle of the student union. You guys are going to be awesome. So anyway, point being that these annulenes can be summarized by the number of carbons, and as you see, I have two different annulenes here. I have 6-annulene, I have 8-annulene. Now here's the deal. Remember that rule I told you guys about planarity? And I said, you know what, you can pretty much just assume that every molecule is going to be planar unless it's drawn really weird. Well, that rule is still going to apply, except not to annulenes. Annulenes are the one exception. Why? Because annulenes can get very, very large. Imagine just putting like a 12 or a 14 or a 20 in front of the annulene. You're going to get this massive ring. And the thing about large rings is that those bonds get wobbly. So they can start to bend, they can start to twist, and they can start to go in directions that will not form a planar ring. Okay? So this can present a little bit of a problem to us college students that don't really know if something's going to be planar or not, okay? We're going to have to memorize some specific trends to be able to predict if something's going to be planar or not. Now, just a note of caution here, this is not something that most professors are going to ask you to know. 9 out of 10 professors are going to just brush over this subject and say, you know, pretty much assume that it's planar unless I tell you. The reason being that in order to really tell if a molecule is going to be planar or not, you have to use X-ray crystallography to measure the bond lengths, and that is not something a professor wants to go into during a college organic chemistry class. All right, so I'm going to teach you these rules just to be comprehensive, but I want you to keep in mind that you might not have to use this on the test at all, okay? So here we go. I just want to show you guys the difference between 6-annulene and 8-annulene. 6-annulene, or benzene, is too small to fold or anything, so it's just going to be planar, whereas 8-annulene would normally be what type of aromaticity? Anti-aromatic, right? This is an anti-aromatic molecule if it's drawn planar, right? But what 8-annulene actually does, because it hates being anti-aromatic, is it folds up. On Wikipedia it calls it like a tube shape. I call it like a taco shape because I'm really hungry. And it kind of looks like a taco, and you can like put some like mystery meat in there and stuff. And the problem with that, or actually the benefit of that, is that these orbitals end up not facing the same direction. And what did I tell you guys happens if your orbitals face different directions? They can't conjugate. And if they can't conjugate with each other, you don't have anti-aromaticity. So that means that 8-annulene actually exists in a non-aromatic state. Isn't that crazy? So what are you supposed to do? You're supposed to memorize that this molecule actually does not look like a planar structure. It looks non-planar or non-aromatic, okay? So now what I'm going to do in the next video is I'm going to teach you exactly what those rules are. Again, remember that you may not even need to use this on your exam, but I'm just going to teach you in case you're curious or in case your professor is really stressing this in class. So let's go on and learn those rules.